at a certain point, you start to ask yourself, like, nigga, am I alive type shit? You know what I'm saying? I don't even know. Like, we don't know the answer. Nigga, I could be living in the motherfucking alternate realm than I was yesterday.
Man, what the fuck is you
what
talking
the
about?
Fuck was that?
Nigga, I'm sorry, man. You know, I was, nigga, I wasn't man, thinking about it. Nah, I did it. I was.
A lot of shit go through this head, bro. I could have just went to sleep and woke up in a different society type shit. You know what I mean? How would I know if my parents not like some shapeshifters or some shit? You know what I mean? Like, how would I know if my parents was real? You feel me? Like, I went to sleep and then I woke up. But if you think about it, I really never went to sleep. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Shit. I would never know if I woke up in some alternate reality. Because when I went to sleep, I have no further recollection of when I went to sleep, right? Because when you go to sleep, you don't know that you sleep. You just wake up. So if you really think about it, a nigga be fast traveling and shit. I go to sleep at 3. I wake up at 10:30. I fast travel, nigga. I don't, you know what I'm saying? I didn't run to 10:30. Nah. I fast traveled. That's the only way to explain that. And that's what I'm going with, and that's what it's going to be. Ain't no such thing as sleep. It's now called fast travel because that's what I did. And that's why sleep is so important, because you get to fast travel constantly.
Yes, sir! This nigga spitting!
Thank you for listening to my TED Talk. I deeply appreciate it. I have a newfound appreciation for different types of women. You understand what I'm saying? A lot of people would say that they have a type, right? And you could say that my type used to be short, light-skinned girls. That's all I've dated, right? And that's fair. Can I get clipped, please? Oh, I gotta get clipped. There's no way I don't have clipped. I'm sitting there talking about the girls I like, and I'm over here busting ass. But yeah, right? Because I've only dated short, light-skinned girls. And when I say dated, it's only been 2 of them. Lately, I just been looking, you know what I'm saying? I just been looking at the Asian girls a little different. You know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't really nothing to it. It ain't got nothing to do with no, I don't like light-skinned girls no more or no shit like that. It's just I have a newfound appreciation for the way that they look, and they look beautiful. That's just what it is, bro. That's what's looking good to me right now. You know what I'm saying? They look beautiful. Not to say that they was ever ugly, but it's like, you know, because first off, I never knew that really that many Asian girls. But you know what I'm saying? I've been peeping, you know what I'm saying? I've been peeping style. And they talking real spicy. They talking real exquisite. Also have a newfound appreciation for tall, skinny girls. I keep saying girls. For tall, skinny women. Because we grown. We grown this shit now. Like, not like tall, like Superman tall type shit. I know. Not on no stretch big type shit. But like on some 5'8", 5'9", 5'10", type shit. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm 6'1", and I can't have you 6 foot. That's just not how it's going to go. You feel me? Even though that is good grounds for a good athlete, like, nah, can't even do it. You dig what I'm saying? Can't even do it because that's too tall at that point. Now you got niggas asking who taller and shit. Nah, can't even do that with you. Can't even do that with you. Because if you start acting out of body, so then we can't fuck with each other no more. Can't be out in public and you got heels on and they asking who taller because you 2 inches taller than me with heels on. That's not cool at all, bro. Like, at all. That's, like, not cool. So, yeah, like 5'9", 5'10", girls. You gotta be fucking shitting me. They coming up strong, I'm telling. Why you shooting my body, bro? Like, damn, what's up? What's up with you? See, now I gotta disrespect you in a whole different language, my nigga. You lucky I don't know Japanese yet. I swear to God, you lucky I don't know Japanese yet. I swear to God, you is, bro. What a nigga that shot my body, bro. I don't have no interest in you, in the rest of you niggas. Big clip on me. Big clip on three. Bro, where's bully? Bro, where's bully? Yes. Now you will be asking yourself why I changed my name to Bro, where's bully? And you see, the answer to that is very simple. It's what I do. And I take pride in what I do. You know what I'm saying? I bully the Bratwurst. You know what I'm saying? So they call me the Bratwurst Bully. And don't forget the 95. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know if y'all seen the bat the first time. But yeah, I keep the baseball bat there so I could, somebody break in, I could knock a nigga head off. And so I could close my door and turn on my light without getting up from my chair. You feel me? Because if I got to get up every time, it's just a nuisance. I just want to know what the reason was. You know what I'm saying? Speaking of bait. Speaking of baseball, y'all ever played baseball before? Nope. Well, don't fucking play it, bro. Don't play that. I'ma fuck him up. Don't give a fuck. Bitch ass nigga. Stop fucking playing with me. Anyway, back to my motherfucking story. So if you're not playing baseball already, don't fucking play that shit. The sport is ass, bro, to be honest with you. I mean, yeah, if you go league, you get a good check. But it's like, what's a good check to some boring shit? You know what I'm saying? Bro, I went to a baseball game. A baseball game. I'm not even gonna get into the story of when I played it yet. I'm gonna talk about the baseball game that I went to. I went to a Tigers game like 10 years ago, right? I think that's their name. Them Detroit niggas, whatever their name is. I'm pretty sure it's the Tigers, but who fucking cares? You know what I'm saying? It's a field trip. And field trip's supposed to be fun. It was the worst shit I've ever experienced in my life. Like, it was literally 3 hours of being bored. Nigga, I could have stayed home and played my PlayStation. The audience of baseball fans that go to the game has to be like old white man over 50. I promise it has to be. It has to be. And that's not even no racial shit. That's just what it is, bro. Like, it's no way. It's no, bro. Fuck that. Bro, that's the only people there. Swear, promise. It just be they family members and a whole bunch of old white men. You know what's even crazier than going to a boring-ass baseball game? It's playing in a baseball game. Like, dog, I mean, no, it's not true. It's not true. It was actually kind of fun. You get to bat and shit, so it's not totally fucking boring. I was third base and best third baseman in the nation. I really could have went league, to be honest with you. Nobody can tell me otherwise. Don't ask me how I missed that first shot. And when I played third base, was the worst time of my motherfucking life, right? We are like, we 10 years old or some shit like that. Was it 10? What grade are you when you're 10 years old? 16, 15, 14. Yeah. Yeah, I was like 10, maybe 9, 10, 9. We playing baseball. We going up against somebody, right? So we 10 years old. We all like 5 foot, 5'1", 5'2", 5'3", maybe, 5'4". Probably that one nigga, right? You know what I'm saying? Some 10-year-old shit, some normal 10-year-old shit. And then we play against this nigga, right? This nigga's like 6 foot. I'm not gonna exaggerate too strong. I don't know if he was 6 foot, but my nigga, we all 5 foot, and he's tall as shit. So we thought he was 6 foot, nigga. Like, nigga, you down there, everybody's a fucking giant to you. In all actuality, he was probably a good 5'8", 5'9". But we gonna just go with 6 foot for the sake of my story, right? Nigga, this nigga look like a high school linebacker. At least that's how I remember it. I could be dragging it, but it's like, who the fuck cares, bro? He go up to bat. They pitch it to him. He slang that motherfucker. He slapped that motherfucker. Next thing I know, ball hit the ground. So I'm like, oh shit, it's a ground ball. I'm big third baseman. I'm finna go lead. Drop down and get it. And my dumb ass got popped in the head because it hit the ground and it popped up. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It hit the ground. I said, ground ball. Said, stupid nigga. Smacked me right on my shit. That was the last baseball game I ever played. They like, nah, you just dragging it because you was little. I'm like, nah, I'm not dragging nothing, nigga. I blacked out. Next thing I know, I was on the bench. Whether I was faking or not, we don't got to get into that because I don't really know, nigga. I got smacked in the head by a baseball. I thought I was dead, nigga. Like, what you talking about? Nigga's talking about I'm faking. Nigga, I thought I was dead, nigga. I thought I was dead, nigga. That shit me hard as fuck. The nigga's telling me I'm faking. Nigga, what, nigga? I'm big third baseman. What I look like faking an injury? Like, it's me, nigga. Ain't that what Kai be saying? It's me, nigga. Like, bro, what you talking about? Nigga, I just got popped in the head. He thought he could move like me. No, boy. Bro, I'm tired of him, bro, because he just sitting there with the L2 on, bro. You lame as hell. That was the last baseball game I played. God forbid I go to one. Shit, I'd be damned. Honestly, you couldn't pay me to go to a f***ing baseball game. Unless you throwing up a meal, couldn't pay me. Because, like, I'd rather not waste 3 hours of my life again. And I wasted that time at such a young age. It's like, bro, I could have did so much more shit with my time. I could have probably beat Black Ops 2 campaign again. Some shit like that. All in that 3 hours, bro.
Do you want to know why I use a knife?